guys, it's Melissa. In this video, I am going to help you get your reds to print red. So I was really struggling with this. This is supposed to be red. To me, it looks too orange. So how did I go about getting that from an orangey red to red when printed on my Roland? So this actually starts with whatever software it is that you are using to create cut lines and how it might be exporting from there, and then what you are telling it to do in VersaWorks. So I'm gonna switch over here and I am in Affinity. This is where I add my cut lines. I have different tutorials on how to add your cut lines, so I'm not gonna go over that here. What I am going to go over is how to get your files to maintain the colors that you want. So this is obviously what I want. What you saw in that original is this, but it was coming out way too orange. So what you wanna do is you wanna go to File, and then Document Setup. Now this is going to need to be done every single time because unfortunately this is the default. So do you see here on the color tab how it says color format RGB8? You have a CMYK printer. That's what your Roland BN2 is. It has CMYK. So we need to make sure that the color profile matches the actual printer. So I'm gonna change the color format here to CMYK8. That also changes this color profile down here to US web coded. There's a whole bunch here. I would recommend just leaving it as that. Now you wanna make sure that it's on converted. And what you can see is that both of mine are grayed out. If you click okay and then go back in there, you can confirm that it's on converted. Okay, so that's what you want. So next thing that you need to do is now you need to export. So for this, we can go to File, Export, and we are going to export as a PDF. That's what we want. We wanna make sure that we are exporting as a PDF for print. Now, you can see I have one that's called Roland VersaWorks. I created that and I'm gonna show you how to do that at the end of this video. So PDF for print is what we want. And now what I need to do is make sure that it knows what I want it to print. So we're gonna go to More. And when we get to More, we now have a bunch of options here. So we need to turn off, uncheck this box right here that says embed profiles. We have already told it the profile that we want to use, so we don't want it to, we don't want any more embedding of color adjustments or anything like that, okay? Now, when you do that, you can press close, and now you are ready to export. So I'm just gonna click export. This is going to export to my desktop as a PDF, okay? And then I'm going to switch over to VersaWorks. So hopefully by now you know how to import. Just go to import and I have the file right here. I will pull it in. And what we're gonna do is when it hits the queue, here it is, we are going to right click, click edit design and settings. Now, from the color management tab, we have a bunch of options. So usually I would hit True Rich Color 3. That gives me great colors typically. When I have a lot of red and even a lot of blue, and I wanna make sure that I am using the colors that I imported, if you check this box here that says Preserve Primary Colors, that is going to be the key in VersaWorks. Don't check the box for Use Embedded ICC, and don't go back up here and reset it, because once you check this box for Preserve Primary Colors, that's where it's gonna change to custom. And then you can click okay. Now when you rip this, and then when you print it, where did mine go? Here it is. What you're going to have is you are going to have your prints go from this orangey red to this true red, okay? And what you can see is a pretty dramatic difference. Easiest to do these side by side this way for you. Okay, so those are all of those little changes. Now, I'm gonna show you how to get that VersaWorks default as best you can in Affinity. Now is a good time though for me to just pause and let you know that if you are looking for one-on-one help with your Roland, with VersaWorks, with your BN, your BN or your BN2, I do offer that through Silhouette U. So if you're looking for one-on-one, same day personalized support, I offer chat support, I offer email, we have a private group, a private email inbox only for members. Silhouette U is what you want, and I will link to that in the description below. Now, hopping back over here to Affinity, where I said that we were going to save that default. PDF print is what we want. More, okay, I'm gonna uncheck this box, See up here now, it says it's not saying anything, and this is not going to be saved. So I'm gonna click Manage Preset, Create Preset. I'm gonna call this Roland VersaWorks 7, and I'm gonna click OK. And now it's going to be there, so I'll close that. So going forward, when I go to export, I can just pick my Roland VersaWorks and I don't have to go into more and adjust. So from there, it is now saved. Now, unfortunately, you can't do the document settings. You can't save that portion of it. So you are gonna have to remember to make sure you go in there and verify that you're using that CMYK 8 and the settings that we talked about earlier in this video. But if you are struggling with your red turning orangey, which I definitely was, you're trying to stay on brand, which is really important if you're for a team or, you know, any type of branding, it's really important to try to hit those colors as close as possible. This is a really, really good way to do it. Now you can see over my shoulder that I also have this color chart that was also printed on my Roland. I'm gonna do another video to show you exactly how to print that out. You don't need to do any kind of setup or anything. It will just print, but I'm gonna show you where to find it in the next video. All right, guys, don't forget, if you're looking for personalized same day one-on-one support for your Roland VersaWorks Flexi Designer Affinity, I offer that through Silhouette U.